if we look at the origin, actually related with the Eurozone problem, which hurt China's export, but also China's labor costs increased dramatically over the past few years. That is also a factor. But most importantly, I think there are two reasons. One is Chinese government wanted to have the quality growth rather than the pure GDP growth. So in a way, they want to put more emphasis on environmental protection and also avoid some kind of over investment. But most importantly is the fact that China in the middle of the major economic structure change from export-led economy to a consumption-led economy with strong emphasis on service sector development and also innovation. First of all, domestic consumption related with the property reform, land reform, and particularly the process of urbanization, as we know, it also slowed down because government put a priority on financial reform, service sector development, but also the public health care and the aging society and the children's education and also sometimes the outflow of capital, and these are all play important role. I think this is all related with the public confidence in China. And if you establish solid, you know, kind of insurance system, and particularly the public health, you know, actually in that area there's some significant improvement, but also urbanization, the process will also change the dynamic. As Chinese middle class increase, I think that eventually that will pick up, in my view. The anti-corruption, it's really become a defining characteristic of Xi Jinping administration. To a certain extent, this is also part of the reason China's economic slowdown, but that's a healthy development. No country should have this kind of economic growth and with such kind of corruption. This is not sustainable. No country can do that. So in a way, this is short-term pain. But on the other hand, that you see that in the past 2 years, the Xi Jinping administration purged about 100 vice minister level leaders and above, including Zhou Yongkang, the person in charge of oil industry and the public security apparatus. So this is a very, very big move. I think that no one can say that anti-corruption is superficial. It's very deep and strong, impressive, and start to change the behaviors of the Chinese officials. China is a huge market, and China's emerging middle class is a historical phenomenon. That the size, you know, at the moment, the percentage probably is still 24 or 25%, but it's already, you know, equivalent to American U.S. population, like 280 million middle class. So that middle class still will be expanding. At the same time, some of the European countries or America, the middle class probably are shrinking. So that's a major geo-economic landscape change.